Okay, I thought a very productive start to the week. It's great to see Zach Fulton out here. Last week we had Juwan James, and I think it speaks volumes for Knoxville, the University of Tennessee, and our football program when these individuals in the National Football League have a week off for a bye week and they choose to come spend it with us. So very proud of these young men, and to have them back, have obviously Juwan last week and now Zach here this week, really excited for them. But I'll just answer any questions you may have.
Didn't see Marlon out there today. What's he dealing with?
Yeah, he's had an ankle injury. We fully anticipate him being back for the game. Rolled it in the game, and he'll practice tomorrow. So all precautionary. He practiced, treatment, in and out.
Coach Jordan, you know, got dinged up several times, kept going back in the other day. It looks like he, you know, probably still feeling it today, but is out here pushing. How valuable is it to have an upperclassman like that?
Well, very valuable. And he's really taken on a leadership role. And we thought he performed, had his best game of his career Saturday. And he's playing with a lot of confidence right now. And he played with a lot of toughness. And you're exactly right. You know, he kept battling through it, did a great job with rehab, and came out today and was 100%, and really gave great effort, and, you know, had a mentality to go back to work today.
How beneficial has it to get Travaris back a couple of games now? Can you see it?
Yeah, he played 37 reps and really gave us some valuable reps at the one technique, and we're going to need that because Owen Williams is out this week. He had surgery on his thumb, so he'll miss this week. So having Travaris back is a huge benefit and a bonus for us.
Expect that to boost the confidence level of the offensive line right now since they got pretty beat up versus Florida?
Don't need to. You know, if you're a competitor and you believe in what you're doing, I think when they say lack of confidence, I think that's an excuse. If you're a competitor and you work exceptionally hard, you build confidence in your body of work throughout the course of the week, doing everything necessary to play winning football. So when everyone says, or somebody says, a lack of confidence, I think that's an excuse. And these players have great confidence. They demand from themselves. They expect to do well, and it's work in progress. And I like the way they came out with the mentality. Again, it's that appetite for winning. What's our appetite to win as a football team, every position, every individual in this football program?
Do you expect that to just be a one-week absence for Owen, or how long do you think?
Yeah, it could be a week to 2 weeks. We'll see how he progresses. You know, we'll go through this week, cut the cast off, and we'll see how he's doing.
Looks like Evan Berry got some reps at running backs.
Yeah, just experimentation. He had all the reps at defense, but every chance we had with individual periods and after practice, again, trying to find a spot for him to utilize his speed.
You talked about needing to get the other running backs more involved in that regard. How's Earl Scott looked his first couple days of practice?
Really like his approach to practice. He adds another level of quickness and speed to our backfield. So again, I like the progression that he's going through right now. You know, he's an individual who's missed some valuable reps throughout the course of time. To have him back right now healthy will be a bonus and add another dimension to our offense.
For those of us who haven't seen him live very much, could you describe his running style?
Yeah, he's very quick, very elusive. He's a downhill runner. But very, very quick with the ball in his hands, makes quick decisions, can make you miss, and has good bursts and acceleration.
Which I think you're starting with five freshmen as you did last week on offense. That's among the most in the nation. When you talk about strength levels, do you see a great disparity in their strength levels when you go back and review the film?
I do, you know, and it depends on your opponent. It's all relative. But again, these are 17, 18-year-old individuals that haven't had the luxury of going through, you know, the development phase of a college strength and conditioning program, but that's where we're at in our program. As you hear me say that, it is what it is, but you see it. That's why we've been very, very diligent in the weight room. That's why we've been very demanding in the weight room, and that's why I've been proud of these individuals, is they understand it, and they get done with the full day of academics, a full practice load, and they're the first ones in the weight room working on their strength levels. And they take great pride in that. We have a long ways to go with that, but they're very, very determined to continue to improve their strength levels throughout the course of a season.
You played 22 true freshmen already. You played a large number from your first signing class a year ago. I mean, what do you want to build the program to? At what point would you like to get that number down to? Is it 14 true freshmen, or how do you balance that?
Well, we just need depth. And where it really, really kind of manifests is throughout the course of a long season is the volume of repetitions on game day. We still have individuals having 75, 80, 85 reps. And over the period of time of a long season, a grind of an SEC season, that takes its toll on a football team. When an individual gets 35, 40 reps, he stays fresher. We've had that luxury with Kurt Majette. Kurt Majette, I believe, played 35, 36 snaps on Saturday. He's in the weight room yesterday and he says, "Coach, this is the freshest and best I've felt since my time here in week five." And again, that's a byproduct, and it's all relative to the repetitions that he has on game day. That's how you get stronger. But when individuals, your body, it's natural, it's a wearing out process. That's why the rest, the recovery is very, very big. But you look at the programs that win consistently, you look at the volume of repetitions, when you have that depth, you're able to do that.
Do you think that maybe that's why Kurt's had a couple of his more productive games?
I do. 2 weeks? I do. I think he's rested. I think he's fresh. He has fresh legs, and it shows on game day.
Coach, if you and I guess Mike and some of the other coaches have watched some of that red zone film with Justin and some of those turnovers and missed throws and things, obviously there's much more than just him there, but has there been a common theme with some of those plays, and what's been the message to him about being in the red zone?
Well, there hasn't been a common theme. The one is just an overall decision process, is making good decisions with the football, managing the football game. It's first and 10. You know, we expect that from a senior quarterback. You know, throw the ball away, as we say, put it on the shelf, play second and 10, that's football. Is a quarterback is in charge of that football, and that football holds all your dreams, goals, and aspirations, and he understands that. Throw the ball away. You know, so some of his decision-making process, some of his other individuals around him, you know, we have to start doing a better job of making plays on the perimeter. You know, when the ball's in the air, we have to own the ball in the air. You know, it's not having negative yardage plays in the red zone. The one time we have a screen play, he's supposed to take a three-step drop. He thinks we've out-leveraged the defense. He doesn't take his three-step drop. The end now folds where we should have been throwing the jailbreak to the field. It's a walk-in touchdown. You know, so all those things. And playing quarterback is the most difficult position job that there is in all of sport. You know, you have, 2 to 2.8 seconds to make a split-second decision. Your fundamentals, your mechanics take care of the football, and everyone running at you, trying to tackle you. And that's why it's a difficult job. But, you know, for the most part, he's done a good job of really limiting the mistakes. But in the red zone, everything is magnified. The speed aspect of it, the field shrinks. And again, we have to go back to winning the red zone.
Sure, it's the same with y'all as he is with us. He comes out and says, "I should have done this better. I should have done that better." How much easier is it to work with a player who just flat out says, "You know, I messed up here. I need to do better at this"?
Well, the great players demand more from themselves than any coach could ever demand. And, you know, if I have to go to him and demand more of him, and it's more important to me than it is to him, then we have the wrong guy. And that's not the case. It means everything to him. He internalizes everything. He replays every play in his mind from practice and in the game. And that's really the storyline of most of these individuals on this football team, is they live this game. And that's what we talk about, live it, love it, like it. You need to live it in our program each and every day. And Justin's one of those individuals that takes great pride in his performance.
What do you think Kemp says is making more of those impact plays as you come?
Well, he's playing with a lot of confidence right now. He's really improved his technique, his man coverage skills. We talk about, as a defensive back, the ability to find the blind spot, find the ball in the blind spot. He can turn, he can locate the ball, he can high point the ball, and he's extremely, extremely competitive. And he's as hard a worker as we have in practice.
What did you see from Mike today?
Yeah, Mike was back out there, full practice, again, competing. Same thing with Jalen. He had limited contact, but we do that the case with all of our running backs just because of the volume of hits that they take. But again, they practice, and it was business as usual.
Did he consistently play better against Florida? Were the numbers just better? Because he made, I know, y'all maybe won that game, some of those third and fourth down catches. catches right. Would have been remembered as big plays.
Alton made some good catches for us, but where Alton needs to take monumental strides in moving forward is his overall consistency. Everyone just looks at stats, and he had some great plays, but also the end of the game, you know, we needed him to stick the nickel, push, stick, and take the middle of the field because the middle of the field was wide open. And everybody, that's the thing is, as the quarterback, praise and blame, it's all the same. When a quarterback throws an interception, all eyes are on him. And sometimes it's the receivers painting the picture for the quarterback or protection or running backs or tight ends. But Alton made some big plays for us, but we need overall consistency in his play from route running, from rep one to all the way to the end of the game.
Any update on Josh Smith? Is there a chance of him?
He will not play this week, no.
Okay.